Wherever you go today, you will hear some common questions. Whether it is the young or the old, men or women, fruit vendors or milkmen, everyone wants to know, is it possible to make payments through the mobile phone? Is it possible to make payments without cash changing hands? You must be thinking, this is really difficult. We will not be able to do this. We are not educated. How will it be possible? It is indeed possible. Yes, even without cash, it is indeed possible. And easy too. As easy as the way you send messages from your phone. So that you get all the answers to your questions, we have invited some experts to the studio from Niti Aayog. Mudit Narayan, Puneet Shukla and Ruchi Gupta. They are a part of the government's team to promote digital payments. Welcome to the show. Mudit, I will start with you. Given the government's push for digital payments, the first question which arises is, what do you mean by a digital payment?
When you pay for any good or service that you've bought directly from one bank account to another without going through cash, that is digital payment. There are several forms of digital payments, and several of us would have tried net banking or some kinds of online payment, which all come under the ambit of digital payments.
Right. Puneet, can you tell us what are the benefits of going cashless for the consumers and the nation as a whole?
So, Barnali, there are very clear benefits for consumers. First is, of course, convenience of doing payments digitally. It's very convenient to pay even smaller and very large amounts of money via digital payments. Of course, there is security. It is much more secure than your cash payment. It is easier for you to rectify any of the mistakes which have been made in the payment. You can approach your bank branch. You have records of those purchase transactions which you have made digitally. For the nation, there are even larger benefits. The first and foremost which comes to mind is the curb on the use of fake notes and its impact on the economy, because once you choose less currency to transact with, the impact of fake currency itself becomes very less. Overall, the tax revenue of the state goes up, because whatever transactions you do via digital payments, every merchant has to deposit its tax to the state. So the overall fund of the state to spend on various developmental programs, the state is able to do that.
Right. What are the government's next steps to promote digital payment?
Yeah, so government has planned several new steps to promote digital payment. First and foremost is, of course, Prime Minister's special interest in making people aware about what are different options to pay digitally. And also there is this communication aims at a behavioral change among us, all the citizens of the country, to go from cash to digital payments. There are other steps being taken, especially by different ministries, wherein, for example, the Department of Economic Affairs is taking steps to increase the reach of common service centers and banking correspondents, just to include the entire rural population into digital banking space, make them aware. And Jan Dhan Yojana was another big step towards making people financially viable and included in the entire space. So there are other several steps being taken as well.
Ruchi, the Honorable Prime Minister in his last episode of Mann Ki Baat encouraged citizens to go cashless. So what is required from our end to be done to get there?
Very rightly said, our Honorable Prime Minister in his last speech on Mann Ki Baat was emphasizing on on moving India towards cashless. Yes, we will be moving from less cash to eventually moving towards cashless economy. Yes, he also emphasized the importance of youth, that youth has the biggest power to drive this entire campaign of moving India to the cashless pathway. So I want to say that we as citizens have been using a lot of options such as net banking or using ATM to withdraw money. But yes, there are a lot of other options which have been talked about. Primarily, there are five options which have been talked about now. The first one is the card. So there are three kinds of card. One is the prepaid card. The second one is the debit card, which we all have. The third one is the credit card. The second option, which is called as the UPI, which is the Unified Payment Interface. 28 banks have their own apps. you can make use through your smartphone, which has the internet facility. The third option, which is available to the users of India, is using USSD. That you can use with any mobile phone, even if it is like smartphone or any feature phone. That is one thing. Then a fourth is the Aadhaar enabled payment system. You can just link your Aadhaar to your bank account and make the payment very easy and simple. Then there is something called as e-wallet. So that is electronic wallet. You keep money in the electronic wallet and make payments. So these are the different options that are available for the citizens to drive the digital payment.
Ruchi, Puneet and Mudit, thank you so much for explaining to the audience about digital payments. In the next segment, we will understand in detail about the various mechanisms required to be undertaken to make digital payments.